Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Okay. So,
good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Just a minute. Yes, good afternoon. So, okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir. Visible.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So I hope yesterday all of you solved that problem. This problem, have you solved it? Because one of your friend Ankita Kumari already solved that. Okay, but and some of you also tried. That's good. Okay. So have you noticed anything in this problem? Hello. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir.
Okay. Okay. So, have you noticed anything unusual or anything problematic in this numerical? Okay. Fine. I just informed you. Notice it because Ankita Kumari already noticed that and he already pointed me that. Okay, so all of you try to notice what wrong is in this numerical, because I deliberately did that wrong. Okay, so now today's work is for you to find that wrong thing. What is wrong in this numerical? Right. And I am switching to this numerical that I gave you to try. Okay, so today we are going to discuss this one. Now, have you tried this one? Anyone?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So, step by step, try to follow. Fine. So, what is given here in the figure, the switch is at first kept at position 1. That means what? The 1 is closed. Okay? The 1 is connected here. That means our first circuit will look like this 100 volt, okay, this 10 ohm, then the switch K, then your 20 ohm, then this inductor. Okay, this one is your 10 ohm. Okay, this one is 10, not 16. Okay, this one is your 20 ohm. This is your first circuit, right? And this one is 0.5. Henry. Clear. This one is 100 volt. So this one, this number one switch is kept and it is at steady condition. So what will happen? At steady condition, this inductor won't work. It will act as a short circuit. Do you remember that?
Yes, sir.
So now, since this is your steady state condition, so I am shorting it. Yeah, I have shorted this one. So now, what is your maximum current that is flowing? I1. Clear. So what is your I1? That is voltage divided by total resistance, that is 100 divided by 10 plus 20, that is 30. Okay. So how much value? 3.33 ampere. Okay. Let me admit your friend. Okay. So is Ankita Kumari present? Hello?
Yes, sir. Present, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. Now, okay, all of you, remember, when we are talking about steady state condition, that means this inductor will work as a short circuit path, correct? So since this one is short circuit, so total circuit is one resistive circuit. So that's why 100 divided by 10 plus 20, they are in series. So ultimate maximum current that will flow through the circuit when one switch is connected, that value is 3.33 ampere. Now, at t equals to zero, the switch is moved to position two. That means our next circuit will look like this. Okay. Our circuit will look like this. Now, look, no source of current is there. No source of voltage is here. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? How will we solve this problem? This problem will be solved using the initial condition. That means what? See, here this inductor will be present. Why? Because this condition, when this switch 2 is connected with K, this total condition for some time, it will act as the transient. Okay, if you see the curve, if you see the waveform, you will see that one transient waveform is there. Okay, suppose it will look like this, or it will look like, so this is your transient waveform. Now, why I am drawing like this? Because see, there is no source here. Okay. Now, why the current will flow? Because I had told you that inductor always store the energy within it in the form of magnetic energy. Right? So, this inductor will help to create that current flow. And the voltage drop will occur across the 20 ohms. So gradually, time to time, the current will decrease from the maximum value. Is the concept clear to everyone? Why the current is decreasing?
No, sir. Please, sir, repeat again.
Okay.
No. Please, sir, repeat again.
Yes. Yes. See, here, this inductor, when this inductor will act as a short circuit path, it is storing some energy because the current is flowing through it, and DIDT for the steady state condition is zero, correct? And since this value is zero, that means no voltage is applied, no voltage is here across this inductor. So it will act this internal energy that is stored in the inductor, because due to the current flow, the capacitor stores the energy as electric field, right? And inductor stores the energy in the form of magnetic field. Right. Yes, any problem? Any query? up to this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So as this inductor, is storing its energy, now when this point, this K switch is connected at 2, that energy, that thing will supply the current here. Okay. So this inductor will help to supply the current in this circuit. Okay. And its energy will gradually decrease. Correct? And how it is decreasing? Because of the voltage drop. Because when current flows through the inductor, through this resistor, voltage drop will be there. Correct? And it will dissipate the heat as a form of heat energy. Correct? So the energy of this inductor will gradually decrease due to the dissipation of heat energy through this resistor. That's why I am showing the graph that the current will decrease like this. The maximum current already you have, that is 3.33. Okay. When the switch is moved at position 2, the current will gradually decrease because the heat energy, that magnetic energy, will dissipate through this resistor in the form of heat energy. Okay, now is the concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now we are going to the next step. Okay, in this circuit, what is your equation then? If you can remember, this is your original equation, right? This equation is for what? For the charging circuit. That means one voltage source is here, okay? One resistor and one inductor is here. This is called the charging circuit because the inductor is charging. Inductor is storing the magnetic energy. In this inductor is storing the energy in the form of magnetic energy. Okay, that's why it is called the charging circuit, right? But here, but in our current problem, only resistor is present and the inductor is present. Okay, so this is called the discharging circuit because the current value is gradually decreasing. Okay, the stored magnetic energy of the inductor is decreasing due to the dissipation of energy in the form of heat in this resistor. Okay, that's why it is called the discharging circuit. That means the inductor is gradually discharging. Okay, similarly, if we are in place of this inductor, I put one capacitor. Okay, if I put one capacitor here, it will be one charging circuit. If I put one capacitor here, it will be one discharging circuit. Okay. So, two types of circuits are here. One is charging circuit, another one is discharging circuit. Okay, and for that discharging circuit, the current value becomes only this. Okay, if you calculate this value, you will get is only this for the discharging circuit. Okay, this is the current value. So if you want to calculate, I can show you. Okay, look, use the KVL law, R into I plus L di dt equals to zero, since no voltage source is present here. Okay, now what I can do, R I divided by L equals to di by dt. Is it okay to everyone up to this step?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, from here, we are doing what? We need to calculate the I. Okay, so di by I. And what is R by L? What is R by L? What is tau? Tau equals to L by R. What is the name of tau? What are we calling this tau?
Time constant.
Time constant, right. So this, we are writing di by I and 1 by tau into dt. Now integrate both sides. Okay. Now what is this value? That is ln I. What is the meaning of ln? Log e base I. Okay. Equals to t by tau plus k. Correct? One constant. Now, at t equals to 0, what is the condition here? At t equals to 0, what is the current value? At t equals to 0, what is the current value? Anyone?
Wait, e to the power.
No, at t equals to 0, what happened? At t equals to 0, the switch just moved from 1 to say 2 position. That means your current is this one. This is your original current na, at the time t equals to 0. Because the switch just moved from 1 to 2 at that point. So, at t equals to 0, your I is 3.33. Okay, so if you put that way, then you will get that K value is ln 3.33. So from here, if you put the values, and then you will get the I value equals to 3.33 into, okay, one minus sign I just missed. Here, one minus sign will be there. One minus sign I just put here. Okay. So 3.33 e to the power minus t by tau. This is your current value. Now, if you have any query, you may ask. Is it okay to everyone? Because there are two kinds of circuit. One is called the charging circuit, when voltage source or current source, that type of sources are, if present, that is called charging circuit, because at that time the inductor will get charged and it will act as a short circuit. Okay, at steady state. And if that voltage source you remove, then that circuit will be called the discharging circuit. Okay, so two types of circuit I just discussed here. Okay, now is that clear to everyone? Is this problem okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So
yes, sir.
This kind of example, another example I will give you today. Okay, let's see whether you can do it or not. Try this at home, no issue. Whether you are right or wrong, try this. Try to do this this type of numerical. Okay, now we are moving to the module 1, PPT 8. Now here you can see the same process that is written here. Okay, it is not elaborative. It is just in brief I noted here. Okay, and I already gave you the description how you can calculate. Okay, whatever circuit if you have, if you want to calculate the current, okay, just use the KVL law. It will help you like this. Ri plus LDI dt equals to 0. Now calculate the current and put the conditions, initial condition or final condition, whatever you know. Right. Now, next is called the RC charging circuit. Now, in place of that inductor, if you put one capacitor, that is called RC charging circuit, just like the previous one. Okay, this is called RC charging circuit. Previous one is called RL charging circuit. Now, if you remove this source, suppose this capacitor is here. Okay, you removed this source, then it is called the discharging circuit. Discharging RC circuit. Okay. Discharging circuit. So two types of circuits are there. Okay. Now, what is the meaning? As you see here, when the switch is closed, the current will flow and the capacitor will be charged. Okay, now what will happen in the steady state? For the capacitor, if you can remember, I equals to C into dV dt. Do you remember this? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if you can remember this one, now tell me at steady state, is the voltage changing? Because this is DC source. Okay. Is the voltage changing time to time?
No, sir.
No. That means your, for ideal case, this what I am telling you, this is your ideal case. Okay. In ideal case, this dV dt is zero. So ultimately, what is your I value? That is zero. That means what? The current is not at all flowing through the circuit. When this can happen, if there is any open circuit, then current will not flow. Correct or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that means for ideal case, this kind of circuit, this circuit will act like this one is R. This one is your capacitor that is acting as one open circuit element. See, the current will not, current is not flowing at all. The current is not flowing. This is your ideal case. Okay, but what is the condition in real practical case? The current will flow up to some time. After that, the capacitor will be fully charged and it will act as open circuit. So at that time, you can say that this is your ideal case. No doubt about that. Okay. In real case, what is happening in real time, this capacitor will get charged, fully charged, but it will require some time. Okay. For that small time, the current will flow. Correct. So we can say that for the first time, the current flow will be very high. At that time, the current will be diminished to zero. Is the concept clear? Concept clear hua ki nahi? Or do I need to repeat again?
So please repeat again.
Okay, look. Then I have to remove this one again. Okay, look. See, for ideal case, what is happening? For ideal case, the voltage is not varying at all. Okay. Since the voltage is not varying, that means dV dt equals to zero. Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If dV dt is zero, that means your current flowing through the circuit is also zero.
Zero. Yes, sir.
Now, if this I is equals to zero, that means what? Somewhere at some point, you just You have done some open circuit, right? That's why the current is not flowing. Correct. So here the capacitor will act as one open circuit. This capacitor, because see, due to this DVDT case, the current is not flowing. So it is the main problem of capacitor, that if you connect one capacitor in DC source, it will get fully charged, and at the steady state condition, that means at infinite time, okay, after infinite time, तुम देखोगे कि ये सर्किट के थ्रू कोई भी करंट फ्लो नहीं हो रहा है. नथिंग विल फ्लो बिकॉज द कैपेसिटर इज फुल्ली चार्ज्ड, एंड इफ इट इज फुल्ली चार्ज्ड, देन डीवीडीटी विल बी जीरो, करंट विल बी जीरो. सो एट दैट टाइम ये सर्किट एक्ट करेगा एज वन ओपन सर्किट. ओके, दिस सर्किट विल एक्ट वन एज वन ओपन सर्किट. Okay, but in real time, what is happening, this capacitor will get fully charged, but it will take some time, either 3 seconds or 4 seconds time. It is not at all charging. Tum log mobile charge karte ho, right? So that battery is also one type of capacitor, right? So is it fully charged when you connect the plug? No.
No, sir.
It is taking some time. Right, that is your real time. Okay, so ideally it should be fully charged when you just plug in that mobile with the charger. Okay, but here in real time that is not happening because it is taking some time. So that time is called the transient time. Okay, that's why this analysis is called transient analysis. Is the concept, अब concept clear हुआ?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir. Yes,
so
sir.
Now, okay, very good. So now we will talk about how to calculate that value of current. Okay, how to calculate the value of current? So how the curve, how the graph will look like at the first time at t equals to zero when you just plug in the circuit, the current flow will be very high. And at the time t tends to infinite, the current will be diminished to zero. Okay, when your mobile gets fully charged, after 100%, it cannot draw any amount of current because at that time it is fully charged. The total current flow in your mobile is fully zero. Okay, now here this is the waveform of the current for the RC circuit. Okay, this is your IC. But in case of inductor, what is happening? In case of inductor, at first the current is zero. As the time passes, the current gets saturated. Right, because after t tends to infinity, at t tends to infinite time, what is happening? The inductor is acting like a short circuit path. So your current is flowing to its max value. RC circuit or RL circuit ka difference samajh mein aaya, or should I need to repeat? The difference between RC circuit and RL circuit, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we are going to the calculation part. Okay, see here, the current is flowing as soon as the switch has been closed. Correct? So the current is flowing, the capacitor is getting charged bit by bit, time to time. Okay, so what is our KVL equation? According to KVL, what is our equation? See here, the voltage Vs, correct? I into R, because I is flowing, current is flowing through this resistor. correct? And what is the voltage across this capacitor? Look, how you are getting this? I already derived that in previous classes, but still, look, I equals to C into dV/dt. Correct. Now, I can write this I into dt 1 by C equals to dV. Correct. Now, do your integration both side. Okay, it is actually VC because this is the voltage across the capacitor. So dVC, okay, that is not dVC, your Damodar Valley Corporation, that is dV suffix C, okay, don't get misunderstood, okay. Now, finally, we are getting what? I into dt equals to V suffix C. So that is the voltage equation. So this value is just written as it is here. Okay. Now, in place of I, you can do this. Okay. C dV/dt you can write in either way. And this I dt 1 by C you can write as V or VC, anything. Okay. So what is this V? This V is the voltage across the C. So you can write here VC, you can write here VC. Okay, it is not written. So for your better understanding, you can write. Because VC here is your variable. Okay, so likewise, if you calculate, your voltage calculation will become this. T by tau equals to minus of ln Vs by V plus K, right? Now, at T equals to 0, is the capacitor charged? No. After the switching on, the capacitor is getting charged bit by bit. Okay, so this is our condition. At T equals to 0, V equals to 0, or you can say Vc equals to 0. So put that condition in the original equation here. So from here you can get K equals to ln Vs, that is your source voltage. Okay, now put that, you can generate one equation after two or three steps. Okay, so you will get this kind of equation, that is V, or you can say Vc, okay? For your better understanding, that is Vs into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. That means the voltage across the capacitor is increasing as the time increases. You can see this. So this is one exponential graph. And what is your steady state? This time duration, this up to 4t, up to this time, it is called transient state, because in this state, the current is flowing. So accordingly, if you look at the current graph, it will look like this. Okay, this is the current waveform. And this is your voltage waveform. Is that clear to everyone? Response?
Sir, can you explain once again?
Which one? Which part?
At this slide.
So graph part.
Okay, only graph. Because this calculation, if you know the differentiation and integration, you can do it quickly. Okay, look, in previous case, this equation is formed. You can do it very easily. In place of I, this part is written C into dVc dt. And in place of this, only Vc is written, right? Now from here, t by tau is kept aside after integration, because dt, if you integrate, it will give you t. Okay, and after this integration, one constant will be generated here. Okay, this integration is done by substitution process. See, the Vs minus Vc is written as Z, substituted as Z. Okay, so this is done in substitution process of the integration. Now, this T by tau, this equation you will get. Now use the initial condition. What is your initial condition? Look, what is your initial condition? Switch is closed at t equals to zero and the current will flow at that time. That means what? At time t equals to zero, the current flowing is zero and the voltage across this capacitor is also zero. That is considered. Okay, so if voltage is zero, that means Vc value will be zero for I equals to zero at t equals to zero. So use that condition here, that at t equals to zero, Vc equals to zero. That is used here. Okay, now this is your Vc. Okay, this is your Vc, this is your Vc, this is your Vc. Now, what is your constant K? The constant K value is ln Vs, because if you put Vc equals to zero, T equals to zero, then your K value becomes ln Vs. Now put that value and you can generate this equation. Okay, and this equation means at T equals to zero, if you check, the Vc value will be zero. And at t equals to infinite, the Vc value will become Vs. Okay, now is it clear? This yes, calculation sir. Part is clear, I think. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now look, how Vc is changing. Vc is changing from 0 to Vs. That means what? This is your zero point. And it is changing exponentially up to Vs. This is your Vs level. Okay, that means at this steady state point, after this steady state point, you will not get any current, because at that point your source voltage, the variation of voltage, the rate of change of voltage becomes zero. Your dvdt becomes zero. Okay, because it already reached the Vs level. So the rate of change of here is zero. So if rate of change of is zero, so I becomes zero. So that curve you can also see from the current equation. This is your, the red line here is the current equation. So you can see that after this steady state part, the current becomes zero. And at the starting, the current is maximum. Okay. Now is the graph clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now,
yes,
this is your total voltage calculation across the capacitor. You can see the current curve here. Okay, this is your current waveform. And what is the value? I equals to C into dVc dt. Vc value you already know. Put that equation here. So after differentiation, you will get this equation. I equals to Vs by R into e to the power minus t by tau. Okay, so now put the t equals to zero here, just like the previous. If you put t equals to zero, what is the I value? Can you tell me?
Vs by R.
Vs by R. So that means your current is nothing but maximum. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So at the time t equals to zero, when you just switch on, the current flowing is maximum. So I max, the current flow is maximum. That value is Vs by R. And at the as the time passes, as the time increases, the current value gradually decreases. Okay, so now let's look when t equals to infinite, what is the current value? What is the current value at t equals to infinite from this equation?
Zero.
Zero, sir.
Okay, so that means the current will be diminished when the system reaches to the steady state condition. Okay, is that clear? So your theoretical part of this module is just I have completed. Okay, for the module one, whatever theoretical part is there, I just completed. Right, now our work is to do various types of numerical based on the theoretical topics I discussed with you. Right, so step by step, these numericals are given here. Okay, and as per my memory, one student was there, I think Shubham, are you present?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in the previous day, whatever problem you were asking, is that okay? Have you solved that?
Yes, sir. Posted in, okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So some of you, that Shubham, Ankita, and Pranay Gupta, I think is here today also. Pranay, are you here? Okay, so some of you already have solved various types of problem, okay, and that's a good sign. Also try to do different kinds of numerical, okay, based on this RC problem and RL circuit. I will give you, okay, try that at home. Now, as per our theoretical part, this is our first problem, that what will be the value of the voltage across the capacitor plates at exactly 0.7 time constant. That means what? 0.7 time constant. Okay, 0.7 tau. Okay, that means 0.7 into L by R. So try to solve this kind of numerical. Okay, some numericals are also given here. Okay, try to solve this. Now I am going to this question number two. Okay, now your work at home today is solve the first numerical. Okay, I am not discussing this with you. This first numerical, I am not discussing here. You have to do that at home on your own. Okay, if any problem you are facing, let me know. Now, this second numerical is the 10 microfarad capacitor in RC circuit shown in the figure has initial charge of 100 microcoulomb with polarity shown and the switch being closed to DC voltage 100 volt comes into play. Find the expression for the current. So here, as you can see, the initial charge is also present in the system. Okay, here source is present. And also the initial charge, that is Q0, is also present. Okay, in previous numerical, what we did, what was our initial condition? Our initial condition was, listen carefully, in previous case, in RC charging circuit, what was our initial condition? At T equals to zero, Q equals to zero, the total charge zero, and the total voltage across the capacitor is zero. This is our initial condition. Okay, but here see, in case of this Q zero here, this has been modified. This is your 100 microcoulomb. Okay, so your system just got modified. Clear? So how to do it? Apply the KVL law just as before. So 100 equals to current I is flowing through the resistor. So 500 I plus 1 divided by C into I dt. Now differentiate with respect to time. Okay, if you can differentiate with respect to time, then one equation you will get. Now there, after this step, use the initial condition. Okay, in our initial condition, what is there? The charge across the capacitor is 100 microcoulomb. Okay, and what is the voltage across the capacitor? You have to calculate that. Okay, how to calculate? I hope you remember Q equals to C into V. Okay, so this Q value is 100 microcoulomb, the capacitor value 10 microfarad. So what is your initial voltage at VC? That is your 10 volt. So that 10 volt is written here. Okay, so what is your initial current flow? Your initial current flow will be 100 minus minus 10, because look at the polarity. As per the numerical, the current is flowing from negative to positive. That means increment of potential, then negative to positive increment of potential. That means your total voltage will be 100 plus 10. So that is done here. Look, 110 divided by 500, so 0.22 ampere. Okay, now at time t equals to 0, your current value is 0.22 ampere. So put that value. That's how you are getting this K equation, and then calculate the I value. Okay, so this is your another one type of numerical based on the RC problem. Okay, now no need to do this right now. Okay, try to understand what I taught you today. Okay, so in this problem, do you have any problem?
No, sir.
So you understood clearly, no? Step by step? Yes. All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So now all of you give your attendances in the chat box. Okay, and there is lab from 3 p.m. for F3F4 batch. Okay, so I just stopped sharing. Okay, so all of you give your attendances right now. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.